Hey kids, good morning. Hope you're having a good Saturday. I'm excited about our video today. As you can see, I've got my basketball and we're gonna have a little basketball competition between me and Estevan. We're gonna see who can make the most baskets out of 10. So let's go check that out. Well, I hope you enjoyed that. That was a lot of fun. Good job, Estevan. He's a baller. And thanks for making me look bad. All right, if you're counting, he made 9 out of 10 shots, and I made 7 out of 10. So he beat me. And so he's good. He's better than me. But that was a lot of fun. And, you know, there was a point to it. It goes right along with the lesson. And if you can grab your Bible, if it's close, I want you to grab your Bible, and I want to show you a verse in the book of Philippians, chapter 3, and Philippians chapter 3, verse number 10. And I just want to read that one verse to you. And in Philippians 3, verse 10, the Bible says that I may know him and the power of his resurrection and the fellowship of his sufferings, being made conformable unto his death. And I want to reread that first part to you. He says, that I may know him. This is Paul the Apostle, the great missionary. And what he's saying is, he's saying that I want to know Jesus. And Paul was saved. He got saved already years ago. But he's saying, I want to know Jesus more. I want to get to know him. You know, it's one thing to say I know somebody, right? We're talking about basketball. Many of us, boys and girls, know who LeBron James is. We know what some of these famous athletes would be and who they are, what they look like. But it's another to say LeBron James is my best friend, right? We get to know them. What Paul's saying is, he's saying, I know a lot of facts about Jesus. We just talked about Easter. And we know the facts that Jesus Christ, he died, but yet he rose again on the third day. We know those facts. But Paul says, I don't want to just know these facts and make a good score on a test or a quiz about it. I want to get to know him. I want to talk to him. I want him to talk to me. I want to get to know who he is. And you know, during this time, we're at home. We're at home a lot more than usual. And I want to ask you that question. Do you know Jesus? Not if you're saved, but are you getting to know Jesus more? We've got a lot of extra time. And I want to give you three ways that we could get to know Jesus more. Number one, real easy, is just read the Bible. Read the Bible. Now, the Bible is a big book. You don't have to read the whole Bible in one night or even in 1 week for that matter. But you and I need to be reading the Bible every day. Even if it's just one verse, read the Bible every single day. And one thing that's helped me when I read the Bible, you know, the Bible is God's word. It's God speaking to us. And one thing that's helped me is when I read the Bible, I have a little notebook. And when I read something that I think God's speaking to my heart about, I write that down. And I'll pray about that. And I'll think about that all day long. And you know, God's used that to help me. And so, number one, read the Bible. Read the word of God. Let God talk to you. But then we need to pray. You know, reading the Bible is God speaking to us, but we need to talk to God. If we're going to get to know somebody, we've got to be able to talk to him. And you know what? God wants you to talk to him. You may say, there's nobody who cares about my feelings or what I'm thinking. You know what? That's not true. God loves you. And God wants to know how you feel. God wants to know what you're thinking. God wants to know what's bothering you. God wants you to tell him what makes you happy. If there's something that you need to pray about that you want different, God wants to know about that. God hears and God answers prayer. That's our God. And if we're going to get to know Jesus more, we've got to talk to him. And guess what? When you pray, God speaks to your heart during that time too. And so we read the Bible, the Word of God, we pray to him. But then the last thing, we've got to live for God. We've got to serve Jesus. You know, Jesus taught his disciples, he said, take my yoke upon you and learn of me. This was a picture. This was a picture of working with Jesus. You say, well, how can I work for Jesus if I'm stuck at home all day? You know, we can make phone calls. We can write cards. We can be kind to our brothers and sisters. We can do things for mom and dad. We can ask if there's anything that needs to be done. Boys, maybe you need to help mow the yard or take out the trash or things like that. Girls, maybe you need to talk. Ask your mom, Mom, what can I do to help? Maybe you can help set the table, do different things like that. And as we serve Jesus, we get to know him. We get to know him. You know, the greatest thing about being a Christian is getting to know Jesus. That's so wonderful. And that's what I want to ask you. You know, that's why we did the basketball competition. You know, if me and Estevan were shooting and there was no basketball goal, we'd look kind of silly, wouldn't we? We'd just be throwing a ball in the air. But you know what? Me and Estevan both, we had a target. We had something we were aiming for. We were trying to hit those baskets. We didn't want to just miss, and we didn't want to just throw the ball in the air. We wanted to aim at that basket and make those shots. You know, God wants us to aim at something. And the verse we read in Philippians, Paul was aiming for something too. He was aiming to know Jesus. So I ask you again, do you know Jesus? Are you getting to know Jesus more? And the three ways we can do that is to read the Bible, pray, and serve Jesus. Live for him every single day. And I know you will. And I know when we get together, we'll have a lot of things to talk about how we got to serve Jesus and how we got to know him more. So at this time, I want to take a quick minute, and I want to do something fun here. And remember, we sent in the silly faces a couple weeks ago, and that was a good turnout. Y'all did real well. And so talking about basketball, here's what we're going to do, okay? We're going to do guess Brother Tom's jersey number, all right? And so I'm going to give you four options, okay? You can either, so you're trying to guess what number my jersey was. You can guess number 3. You can guess 22. You can guess 15. Or you can guess number 7. So those are your four options, okay? And so just what you have to do is get your parents to help you, and you email your guess at info@seattlebaptist.org. And so I'll announce those winners next Saturday, including a picture of me in my jersey when I was in high school. And so whoever gets that will get a prize in the mail. And I think that'll be a lot of fun. So I hope you all have a good rest of your weekend and a good Saturday. And we'll see you next time. Bye.